You don't have to wait years to start editing like a pro. It's simpler than you think. These 11 pro editing hacks will save you hours and make your edits look cleaner. Let's say you have this clip sitting at the end of your timeline. Now you feel it would look better right after your first clip. Instead of dragging it around and messing up your edit, hold Command plus Shift and press the comma key. That moves the clip to the left. On Windows, use Control key. And to move it to the right, same thing. Just press the dot key instead. What if you need to change the duration of several clips at once? Let's say you have 3 clips on your timeline, and you want each one to be exactly 5 seconds long. Just select all the clips, switch to trim edit mode, then right click and choose change clip duration. Now type in your duration or pick one of the presets. And boom, each clip snaps to the same length and your timeline spacing updates automatically. Imagine when you need to edit clips with surgical precision. Okay, here we have got a nice rock climbing shot. But the start and the end aren't perfect. We only want that jump moment. So switch to trim edit mode, hover your cursor over the middle of the clip. Now just click, hold and drag to the left. In the viewer, top left is your new start frame and top right is your new end frame. Dial in the exact moment you want, then let go. And you have done a pro level edit with almost no effort. Sometimes you need to create space in a crowded timeline without messing everything up. Let's make space for a B-roll clip right after the second clip. Place your playhead on the third clip, press Y, then hit the plus key and type how much space you want. Let's say 5 seconds and hit enter. All the clips on that track jump to the right. But what if you also have media on other tracks and you want everything to stay in sync? Undo that first. Now press Option or Alt plus Y, then the plus key again, and type your time and press enter. Boom, everything moves together. There is no easier way to add B-roll than this. Move your playhead to the end of the second clip and press I to mark an endpoint. Then move it to where the next clip starts and press O. That's your out point. Now move your B-roll clip in the source viewer. Scrub to where you want it to start and press I to set endpoint there. And finally click Overwrite Clip. This is probably every editor's favorite hack. Let's say you decide you don't need a clip in your timeline anymore. Instead of deleting it and then closing the gap manually, just press Shift plus Backspace. It deletes the clip and instantly closes the gap. Alright, here is the one of the most advanced and efficient delete hacks in DaVinci. Let's say you want to remove the first part of this fourth clip. Place your playhead exactly where you want the cut. You don't even need to select the clip. Press Command plus Shift plus left bracket and everything before the playhead on that clip disappears. And if you want to delete the part after the playhead, press Command plus Shift plus right bracket. With this hack, you can drop sound effects super fast and perfectly timed. Let's say you want to add a sound effect to this clip. Move your playhead over it and press X. That instantly marks the in and out points. Now double click your sound effect to open it in the source viewer. Then just grab it and choose place on top in the timeline viewer. Sometimes your clip has audio, but you don't want to use it. You only want the video. Instead of unlinking and deleting audio in the timeline, just grab the video icon in the source viewer and choose Overwrite Clip in the timeline viewer. Done. Video only. Or here is another way. Let's undo that. Click the A1 track button to disable that audio track, so it won't take any new audio. Then press F10 to do an overwrite edit. Did you ever ruin an almost finished timeline just by inserting a clip in the middle? Here's how to avoid that disaster. Let's say you want to add a clip right after your second shot. Move the playhead to that point in your timeline. Now load your clip into the source viewer. Press I to set your endpoint where you want the clip to start and O to set the out point. Finally, click Insert Clip. With this pro hack, you can time your sound effects with surgical precision. We have got a helicopter scene, and we want the loudest point of the sound effect to hit exactly when the helicopter gets closest to the camera. First, press X to mark in and out points around the clip. Now move your playhead to the exact frame where the helicopter is nearest to the camera. Then lower your SFX in the source viewer and move its playhead to the peak of the waveform, the loudest point. Finally, perform a replace edit. And that's it. If this helped, make sure to like the video and subscribe